Hello folks, so in this video we will learn how we can create a custom scroll bar in a React project. So what do I mean by a custom scroll bar? So when we are using Chrome, and let's say I'm searching something in Chrome, custom scroll bar, and as you can see, Chrome has created a default scroll bar for us. But let's say in our particular React project, we want a different looking scroll bar. Let's say I want the corners to be rounded or something else. So how can I create a custom scroll bar is what we will be looking at today. So here I have a default React project and a custom scroll bar. That's just a text. And I also have Tailwind CSS configured. As you can see, we are using Tailwind. So first of all, let me create a scroll bar. So after the custom scroll bar, I will create a div. And inside a div, I will create many divs. Let me write lorem 10 and I will just copy this line and I will paste it many times so that I will get a scroll bar. So as you can see, I have a default scroll bar which I don't want. I wanted to customize and create a good looking scroll bar. And let me also give a padding of 4 so that we have some space. So how can we create a new scroll bar? So when we configure Tailwind CSS, we will have a file called tailwindconfig.js. And right now this file is empty. Now in the plugin section, we have to add few things. We will add a function. And as a parameter, we will pass add utilities. Utilities. And inside the function, we will create a new utilities. And this will contain like all the properties of our scroll bar. And after this is created, what we need to do is basically do an add utilities. So this is the parameter that we are passing inside our function. And here we will pass the new utilities. And we will pass two more things. And responsive. And the next one is hover. So hover is like when we are hovering over the scroll bar, as you can see, the color is changing this property. Now inside our new utilities, first of all, we will write scroll bar webkit. Now this is a default name, so you cannot change it. And as part of the scroll bar webkit, we can like add few more properties. So we have to add like this. Ampersand colon colon webkit scroll bar, and here we can add the width. So let me give the width as, let's say, 16 pixel. We have to add in quotations because this is not like CSS, it's some properties we are adding inside a function, so we have to maintain a different format. And after that we will give a comma. And we will add few more properties. So for example, we will add WebKit scroll bar track. So WebKit scroll bar track. You will see what these things mean soon. But for now, just follow along. And here we will give the background. So background, we will give, let's say, light yellow. So to give a brief idea, this is like this background. So we have a scroll bar here, and in between the two arrows that you can see at the top and bottom, there is this place, and which is the background of the scroll bar. So the color we want in this case is, let's say, light yellow. And after that, what we will do is we will add some styles for the thumb. So let me give WebKit scroll bar thumb. And in this case, we will give a background color of, let's say, violet. And we will give a border radius of, let's say, 20 pixels. So the thumb is basically the top of our like scroll bar. So I think that's all. And now what we need to do is inside our app dot not CSS, app.jsx file in our container. So basically wherever we are keeping all our divs, Here we will add our scroll bar webkit. So let me add scroll bar webkit, and you see some changes. You don't see, and that is because we have added the scroll bar webkit in the wrong place. This is our heading. So what we need to do is add here in the container which is containing all our Lorem Ipsum. And now if I add our scroll bar webkit, you will definitely see some changes. Still no. And that is because this Lorem Ipsum is taking all the space. So what we need to do is we have to define some height of the container. So right now the height is like, there is no height. It will just keep on going along. So I will give a height of 64. Now, how do I know that I have a height of 64? Now, let me give a border too. And as you can see, this is the height. But what happens is it is being shown even after the height. So what we need to do is overflow, not auto, overflow y auto. And now you can see that we have a something like a scroll bar. Let me give a better height. So it is now 128, and as you can see, we have some problem, and that is we have a height of 128, and somehow the default scroll bar of the screen is being shown, and there is kind of an issue. So what we can do is let me give a bigger height. Let's see. I think 128 is not present. So if I give a 96, yeah. So this is good. So as you can see, I have a height of 96, and I have all the Lorem Ipsum, and I have a custom scroll bar. Now I think the width is too much. So what we can simply do is go to tailwindconfig.js, and here we can maybe reduce the width to 12. As you can see, it is now 12. Let me make it 8. And we can also change the colors. So let's say, let's make it red. Okay, so this is the background. So background being red, I think is not that good. Light red, I think, I'm not sure if there is such a color or not. So let me make it not blue, light blue. Yeah. Okay, anyway, I mean, you understand, you get the point, what we need to do. So I'm sure you can do it. And thumb. Achha, background color is something else. So let me make it blue. So this is the background color of our scroll bar, and I think this is fine. Now, one more thing I need to address is there is actually a more simpler way of doing all of this. So we don't really need to, you know, take so much headache. And that is, we have our index.css file, right? And this index.css file is being imported in the main.jsx file. So what we can simply do is I will do some copy paste, okay, because I don't like, you know, writing so much CSS. So I will just copy paste it here, and instead what will I do? As you can see, there is some changes, right? So because it is overwriting changes that we have here over our tailwindconfig.css. So here I think with the scroll bar width, okay, let me just do one thing. Let me just remove all of it. Let me just do a control Z. And as you can see, it has a different kind of style, which is coming directly from the index.css. So what we can do is, let me just give some better background color. Let me make it, let's say red. Okay, not background should not be red. I think background can be light coral. And I think background shouldn't have a border radius. So this is fine. Now background color of the thumb, we can make it red. And border radius is 10, which is good, but border 2 pixels solid is too much. I think 1 is good, or maybe 2, not more than that. And 2 pixels solid, let me give white smoke. And background color, I think this is the background color of the hover, right? Yeah, so as you can see, when I'm hovering, it is coming like this. So what we can do is, for the hover, I can give it a dark red. And now it will come like this. And can we give a cursor pointer? Let's try to give cursor pointer. So now what will happen is, if I hover, it will have a, like, it will have a hand. I'm not sure a hand is good or a cursor is good, but you get the point. I mean, you can play around. That's not a big issue. And one more thing that I just wanted to do, I kind of forgot what that is. But anyway, you get the point. This is how we can add scroll bars. And you may wonder that since we can add so easily in index or CSS, why do we need to do so much things in Tailwind config? Because we may need the Tailwind config files for configuring other things also, which may not be very appropriate using in the index or CSS file. So it may be a wise idea to learn how to use the Tailwind config.js file also. So that's the whole point, and this is how you can make beautiful looking scroll bars in your React projects, rather than using the custom dumb scroll bar that like Chrome is giving us. So if I remove everything, you will see the scroll bar looks so dumb. But if I have something else, like we can customize and we can make it better. So that's all for this video. I hope you have enjoyed the video, and make sure to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you next time.